What's up, everybody? I hope you guys can hear me okay. How's everybody doing? So here we go. Today is not an instructional video by any means, but I thought this was a pretty cool project. These don't come around all the time. And yeah, so we got that picture of the shark in the screenshot, and I've kind of laid it out here with a white colored pencil. And I'm just gonna go ahead and start layering in. I'm just going to start with the opaque white straight out of the bottle. That way I could get the, like, the brightest whites. What's up? The brightest whites right away. What's up, Easy Airbrush? What's up, Air Todd? bienvenidos todos. So, como pueden ver, hoy no va a ser un video instruccional. Nada más es un video muy suave. Y estamos pintando qué es lo de abajo de un Corvette. Lo de abajo de un hood. Oh, la capa del motor. Sí, nomás voy a empezar con blanco opaco del derecho de la botella. Y vamos a empezar aquí. So here I go, I'm just gonna go ahead and start down here by layering in all the white that's gonna be for the blue. So enjoy, guys. Put some music on. Do whatever it is you do. I have music going. As always, I'll be looking at the chat, so if you have questions or something, or if you just want to talk, go ahead and ask me in the chat, and I'll be looking over and taking a gander every now and then. Now, when it comes to this picture, I want to give a shout out to the artist. Oh, I forgot his name already. I think it's Wayne Dowson. He has a YouTube channel. I'll make sure to link it once I'm done. With the picture, I'll put a link down in the description, down to his channel, and this is actually like a digital painting of his, and it was not a, I thought it was a picture, but it turns out it's not, but this is a picture that the customer brought me, and he was like, this is what I want, so I couldn't really just argue with him, so. I'm just making sure to get some of these lines in right away. Because I tried to find information about the picture, that the customer brought, and that's what I ended up with. It ended up with that guy's YouTube channel, and that's as much information as I could find. So. But again, we're not trying to like just copy his image. We're gonna kind of take it and kind of make our own version of it. So, what's up, James Melton? But using his picture as a reference. Jeez, what are you guys breaking over there? All right, get that in there. Just gonna get a good foundation in because we're gonna do this whole painting in color, so we're gonna go ahead and just it'll be a little bit rough with it, I guess. But we need a good white foundation so when we lay our colors in, they'll be nice and bright. That looks really bright on the camera. You have work to do, huh? I don't know. Can somebody translate Alessandro's message there? Bust out that Google Translate, yo. Let me know what that is. Something about an image. You're Brazilian? Cool. I am not Brazilian. Right on DE Pitbull. I'm just gonna say Pitbull from now on, bro. I don't know what the DE is about. Oh, yeah. Very reflective image. Wait, Pibble, you're the Dutch guy, right? Never mind. I know you, bro. That's right. We've had this conversation already. Sorry. That's my bad. That's like me asking what kind of paint do I use, except I did it about your name. At least I hope it was you, right? Oh man. I should probably start writing some of this down. Now, I personally wanted to do something with the logo and like, add some masking and stuff. The owner of the vehicle said that he did not want that. He wanted to focus more on the shark painting because the car is some kind of, I forget the name of it. It's some silver, but it's like shark. The name of it is like shark silver or something like that. So, I don't know. Something he wanted to match it with the name of the color of the car. I don't know, man. I just know he picked this picture, this is what I'm painting. I'm gonna try to make it as good as possible. Just going back, building it up little by little. Every coat that you put on it just gets a little brighter, you know. I say cool and then I start going at it. I'm you're the TO double D, yeah, dude. That Todd. Air Todd. He's an airbrush master, bro. Does dagger strokes like nobody's business. I'm smiling so hard. It doesn't say that. So yeah, I don't know if you guys can tell. It's starting to look pretty good just with the white. But let me come back in here and I think we'll start with some probably some Maui blue. So do me one favor real quick, everybody in the chat, either go share it out, do your favorite thing, but I'm gonna switch colors and do these couple things right here, like and subscribe. Got my Maui blue. And I thought 30 seconds would be fast enough to change colors. It turns out it's not. I should have these colors ready, but I wasn't that prepared. Nor did I care that much, because I could just do it. Alright, so I'm just going to start by doing some of the shark colors here. Layering in the Maui blue. Kind of thick, because we're going to go back over it. Somebody would be calling. Hello?
Starting Monday, March 16th,
2020, Pueblo School District 61. Okay. I've already got that message. I'm just trying to get this Maui blue spray out pretty good. Oh, come on. Oh. Well, maybe it would help if there was something in the bottle, huh? Felt like there was something in the bottle, but it turns out it's nothing but a little spitz worth. So let me just put some in this bottle real quick. Get all these colors kind of put in, and then we'll start coming in with the Talon, or the Revolution, with some black, and we'll start detailing it out. But I really want to do all this background stuff first. Started with Maui blue. It's a good light blue. It's a transparent regular. It's not like a fluorescent color or anything like that. And it's kind of a neutral color. It's not like super bright. It's just nice. Just put that in there. What is this about masks? Now we can officially continue to wear our masks outside. Oh my gosh. Coronavirus jokes? Is that what we're doing now? Then I'm just going to switch off to some regular bright blue, which is contrary to its name. I mean, it is pretty bright once you spray it, but when you look at it, it doesn't look very bright at all. And we're just going to start with the bright blue. just start kind of working it in here. Start down here. Working our way around. I like leaving these like streaks in there. It makes the whole underwater just look that much better, you know. You got nice little lights coming through. Sun rays, you know, coming through the waves. I wish I was on a beach right now. I wish I was on the beach right now. It'd be nice. Working it kind of fast and loose. Then we're gonna come back in. Work in all our details slowly. Yeah, I don't know. I was never a fan of the Caribbean blue. I've always liked the Maui blue. And they've always been kind of similar, so I never felt the need to get both. Like, I don't know. Seems unnecessary. Working in the blue real good right here. And for some reason, I got this Just Beats playlist on Amazon Music, and it's like going really good with the loud paint. I wish you guys could hear it. It sucks. I hope you guys got some good music going. I like listening to music, and sometimes all I need is a good beat, man. Right now, these beats is good. I like Smurfs Blue. Alright, cool. Interesting conversation you guys are having. Alright, so now I'm just gonna put in some orange and some brown here on our thing here. Just starting with some orange. So what do you guys think so far? Look alright? So looking kind of close somewhere on there. And I'm going to switch off to some brown here. I'm going to start off with light brown. I'm standing up for this part because it's high up. The artist Smurf can also airbrush. Yeah, I think on the counter there's some. What are you wearing? I don't know what you guys are saying there. You don't need a hair dryer? Not today. doing enough colors and going enough in between the areas, it's gonna dry by the time I go back and do more detail, like on the shark and stuff. It's gonna be dry, so. But I'm gonna put some yellow over that dirt area there. Land, I don't know what you want to call it, just to make that all kind of pop a little bit. Go. Gives us our nice golden ground color. Looks really good. And now I'm going to come back in with some dark brown. And I'm going to go ahead and detail out the top. Or the ground, I guess. And then I got to come back in with the white once we're doing white and do the clouds. But the rocks will be done. Reference anymore for these, because the reference on this part is where really where you could tell that it's a painting the most, because it just looks kind of bleh. So I'm gonna come and do my own little details. Even if mine looks bleh, at least it's my bleh, not somebody else's bleh. Right on, Pitbulls. We'll see you later, man. Thanks for watching, as always. So now I'm just going to come back in with some white. Sit back down. Sweet. And we're going to go ahead and just start kind of getting in most of these details in here and really shaping everything out. Yo, thank you, KO. You know, I'm just happy all you guys still watch. I remember not that long ago, even maybe 5 years ago, and people were saying that airbrushing was a dying art. Oh no, yeah, not that many people airbrush anymore, and you know, there's really no money in it. All kinds of stuff I heard. And here we are, still going strong. Not just me, but all you guys watching. It just still shows that there's a community out there. People just like to watch, like to learn, like to paint on their own time. We don't have, and not everybody has to be, you know, Johnny Badass, you know, with an airbrush. I get a lot of messages where people just say that they find it relaxing to watch, or that they like watching the artwork get made. That's always interesting to me. So I always say thank you guys for watching. It's not just for me. Kind of like for the whole industry, man. The reason why I keep doing it. Keep everything going. Keep it alive for everybody. I know Raps, man, when Raps came out, they took all my airbrush business. People didn't want an airbrush, man. Everybody wanted Rap. And then when Dip came out, everybody was like, I want my car dipped because I don't have to commit. You know, I could take it off. Then all the, you know, all the truth started coming out. And it's like, if you leave that stuff on for too long, it doesn't come off very easy. You can't actually get a gloss coat on there very good, like to make it look shiny like a mirror. You know, you can't really do that with Dip. I mean, you can. I'm not challenging you. And I'm sure if you really wanted to, you could, but it's not easy to do. It's not just a simple application method. And I think slowly but surely, you know, airbrush artists getting that trust back. And then there was the whole surge of, you know, people that just, man, you know how many works I got that were just like, yeah, we had somebody paint it, and then we had to get it redone. You know, bring it to me to get it redone. But we still here. We still here, all of us. Still painting. Still having a good time. And even if you're just painting for yourself at home, you know, it's just a lot of fun to do. Zoom in and out. Let me see here. I know it's kind of bright in here, but I need it bright so I can see. And I also don't need you guys like in my way, so let me see what I can do here. Just move this thing this way. There you go. Kinda. Alright. Leaving again? Yeah. We'll see you later. I hope that helps a little bit. What, did you forget to feed your hamster or what?
No, I was going in slippers, but it looked like it just poured outside for like 5 seconds.
Oh, good luck. Cat, what are you doing on my desk? Alright, thank you. Thank you for getting off. Let's see. decide what exactly I want to transfer over from this image. That also makes the shark look more aggressive, your reference. Just to add to the overall effect. But I think we got it good enough. We can start coming in with some black. Oh wait, let me do some white on these clouds up here. White on the clouds. See up here? What is that? A shark?
Yeah, I don't like sharks.
You don't like sharks? Sharks used to be your favorite. Oh, you only like them in your toys? Not in your water? Yeah, that sounds pretty good to me too. Blue on the sky there. That edge, hit that edge with the blue. Looks good. I'm also gonna go over blue over some of this stuff in here just slightly. Just so that when we do the final white highlights, we'll have really nice bright white highlights. Well, let's get some of that brown covered up on the edge right there. Black. It already looks so good. Here we go. Here's the true test, though. We got to start detailing in the shark. Let's get you guys in close. Thank you. The t-shirt paint or the auto air, huh? I'm using the Createx airbrush colors. Same ones I use for all my videos. I've never used the auto airline for any reason, even on vehicles. I just never understood why they needed a separate paint line, and I understand they have separate colors and stuff, but everything is compatible. So like the reducer, when the regular line, you can use it on the auto air line, which leads me to believe it's made of the same stuff. Most likely is just different mixes. So I don't know. And I never had a trouble with the regular one. And I don't even know when was the last time I seen one of those auto air cans in a store. I'll just say that. Maybe I just don't get out enough, I don't know. At least the paint stores that I go to, they don't carry auto air. What do you guys think? How's it looking so far? I can't even ask that if you guys are that close. Makes more sense when you guys are out here. Yo, what's up, Air Todd? Look at him with the skull. Oh, he's so sick. Back and forth, huh? Busy man, that's good, man. I wish you guys could see what I'm seeing, because this does not look like what I'm seeing. Yeah, that looks more like what I'm seeing. Just focusing in too much, man, can really make it look weird. This is better, okay. I'm trying to get you guys in position without being in my way. Just moving along. There's no reason why this should take me 10 years to finish, right? Thank you. looks pretty good. Nice. Did you also paint a great white shark? I don't know why that was hard to say all of a sudden. going to do a little bit of black on these mountains. Aquaflow True Blue Transparent. I haven't used Aquaflow in such a long time. I found the color chart that I had for them for when I would order colors just the other day, and I threw it away. It was old. It was dated, it was 2007 or something like that. Pretty old. I should have kept it just from, but it was nasty too. I didn't want to keep it. It was like buried deep in some stuff, so. Maybe I'll give him a try again. The thing I remember about Aquaflow and the reason I had to stop using it was because they would always have a problem keeping certain colors in stock. And so when you go to order, they'd be like, oh, that's not in stock. And you could send it out as soon as it's ready. And sometimes some of the waits were like, you know, 2 to 3 weeks. And it's just like, I need that paint like today, bro. Createx was just super convenient. It was basically laying around. There you go. I think that looks pretty good. I'm just going to come back in and do the final white highlights. And that way we get everything looking super crisp and bright and clear. And maybe if I move you guys back, it won't be so bright. Because right now the white looks super bright on the camera, and it's not that bright. Anyway. Where's the blood? Yeah, no blood in the picture. I thought about it. Maybe I should have, I mean, I still can. So we're going to add some of the light rays, kind of shining down on the shark here. Yeah, that's the only way to get Aquaflow is you gotta order it. You gotta call them in. You gotta talk to them directly. I don't know, man. In the times when I had to shop in the mall and stuff, and we were just ordering shit like crazy. Hats, shirts, paint. We were doing so much work, it was just ridiculous. And anytime anybody told us we had to wait for something, it was just like, oh man, you wait? You don't have them now? We were spoiled, I guess. What's his name? Bill Edwards is his name. The name of the guy from Aquaflow. I'm pretty sure it's his name. I don't know why that looks so white on the camera, but There you go. Look, if I do this, you guys can see all the shading in there. But if I do that, it's like super. I don't know why it does that. See that? That looks way different. Why does it do that, yo? I wish it just looked like this the whole time. Oh, dang. Todd and his twin are here, yo. The Todds. I need to invest in a good camera. Maybe using a webcam isn't doing my work justice. So, yeah, like that just looks so different in person. Yeah, like if it just toned it down to there, look at it, you can see all that. Do that and all that right there looks horrible. I don't know why. Sorry about that, guys. Maybe if we get enough members, that'll be the first thing I get is a really nice camera. No, no, the webcam I'm using now is also a few years old now. I don't know. There you go, that looks pretty good. Wow, that looks really good actually. There you go. That looks pretty darn good. Wow. Again, you guys don't really see what I see, but I wish you guys could. It's like if I put it like where? Where's the magic spot? Now it's not going to change. Whoa. Let's put you guys. That's different too. I don't know, but whatever. You guys get the idea. Oh, there you go. Look farther back. That looks pretty good. Not really. Let me get as much of that background. There you go. Nope, that's still too bright. Look at how bright that background is. Why is that background so bright? There you go. Nope, come on. Is it because it's black? Maybe because it's black. See, because if you get that background in there. I really think a good camera is like $400, dude. Which the channel doesn't make that like a long time. So look at that. Why is the back so bright? This, yeah, whatever. You guys get it. I tried it. I tried to get it as best as I could. Anyway, guys, I hope you guys liked that video. That was what, maybe an hour and a half? An hour and 40 minutes, and we got our shark on there looking super dope, super clean. I really don't know what else I could add to it to make it look better. It looks really sick. Looks like that shark's right next to me underwater, and I wouldn't want to be there. Pretty much. Like, maybe putting it in close? Not really. Right on. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Art Todd. I hope you guys like it. And as always, thank you guys for watching. And yeah, we'll see this little outro. I'll let it sit on it for a few seconds, and then we'll see you guys in the next video. Later.